Hello students, in this video I will discuss some of the reference to the context question answers. For your kind information, reference to the context will be there in your examination, and the weightage is 3 marks, 3 to 4 marks. What exactly in a reference to the context happens, that a quoted line is given and 3 to 4 questions are given. Each carries 1 marks. Now, answers are to be written from the quoted lines, or in terms of the quoted line or quoted expression, the questions are being set. Now, answers are to be written according to that. So, let us come to the very first answer. Here, not only one question, many questions that can be from a single stanza been described by me. So, stanza number 1. The cardboard shows me how it was when the two girl cousins went paddling, each one holding one of my mother's hands, and she the big girl some 12 years or so. All three stood still to smile through their hair at the uncle with the camera. Now, these are the lines, the very first lines of the poem, first few lines of the poem. At the very beginning, we get these lines. Now, what are the questions, probable questions can be set up from these lines? Number 1, what does the cardboard refer to? Very important question. It came previously in the exams also. The cardboard refers to the childhood photograph of the poet's mother and her cousins who went out to the beach. Who was the big girl and how old was she? It is written in the second line only. Second, third line, in the fourth line also, she the big girl some 12 years or so, it is already written. So it is very easy. I already told you that the questions are set up related with the stanza. So answers you will find from the stanza only. You have to write in proper English, that is the main thing. So see the answer. The big girl was the poet's mother. She was then 12 years old. How did the cousins go paddling with the poet's mother? The girl cousins Betty and Dolly went paddling with the poet's mother holding her hands. Who does all three refer to here? All three refers to the poet's mother and her two cousins. Why did they smile through their hair? They smiled through their hair because they were posing for a photograph. Explain the contrast given in the last two lines of the first stanza. What are the contrast we can find? The last two lines of the first answer. So let us come to that answer. The contrast is between the sea and the human life. The sea had remained the same for all these years, but we know by this time that human life is transient. But the humans have undergone changes. I already told about this, transient. The poet's mother grew up and now she had been dead for some time. And that is 12 years, the same age as the girl being depicted in the photograph. What does the word cardboard denote in the poem? Why has this word been used? Why the cardboard been used? The photograph in the poem is called cardboard because it is too difficult to call it a photograph, because it is a very old photograph, very old. Having lost its color, grandeur, texture, and having lost the clarity of its images in it, the photograph is now just a cardboard because it is not clear, it is still hazy. But having said that it is not clear, it is still hazy, but it evokes strong memories. It evokes very strong memories. Now it has lost the clarity of its images. Now it is simply like a cardboard. What had the camera captured? The camera had captured some happy moments from the childhood of the poet's mother. It was a scene taken from a beach where she had gone with her cousins and her uncle for a sea holiday. The girls stood huddled together. Huddle means they are all gathered together. The poet's mother in the middle, held tightly by her cousins, Betty and Dolly. What scene from mother's childhood had been captured in the photograph? Who had taken the photograph? The scene had been captured in the photograph is from the poet's mother's childhood, when she went for paddling with her two cousins. The uncle had taken the photograph. It seems that the three girls were all dressed for the photograph. So actually plan was to take a photograph. So they were funnily dressed. Now I am moving to stanza number 2. As usual, there are some questions also from this stanza. A sweet face, my mother's, that was before I was born. And the sea, which appears to have changed less, washed their terribly transient feet. Now what are the questions can be from these three lines? First question, where was the poet's mother when the photograph was clicked? Very simple, we know by this time. The poet's mother was near a seashore, or we can say was on the seashore with her cousins posing for a photograph. When did this incident take place? This incident took place when the poet's mother was 12 years old. How is the poet able to remember her mother's childhood? The poet is able to remember her mother's childhood by looking at the photograph. What has stood the passage of time and what has not? Obviously, the seashore, this has withstood the passage of time. But human life, as we all know, man is mortal and it is transient. It is written in that way only in this answer. The sea had stood the onslaught of time. I already told you all regarding this. It is still the same. However, the poet's mother and her cousins underwent changes. Her mother grew up to be an adult and now she is no more. Because at the end we get to know that now the poet, not only she misses her mother's laughter, just like her mother used to miss her childhood days. Apart from that, the tragic thing is that she misses her a lot because now she is no more. What has changed over the years? Does this suggest something to you? The sea had not changed over the years. It is still the same. The sea symbolizes immortality, indestructible in nature, against the transient existence of other creatures in the nature. Transient means something that is temporary. Human life, it is transient, it is ephemeral, that is temporary. But the sea symbolizes something that is immortal. Now we are moving on to stanza number 3. And what are the questions that we can gather from this stanza? Some 20-30 years later, she would laugh at the snapshot. And she would say, "See Betty and Dolly," she would say, "and look how they dressed us for the beach." That is the quoted line. Now what are the questions we can get from these 4 lines? Who would laugh at the snapshot after 20-30 years? Obviously it is the poet's mother. The poet's mother would laugh at the snapshot after 20-30 years later. How did the mother remember her past? The mother remembered her past with nostalgia. Each time she looked at the photograph, she felt sad about her lost childhood and adolescence. Because it was a sad moment for her also, because that childhood, she won't get that back. And what is the thing that troubled the poet? The loss of her mother's laughter as well as the loss of her mother. Who were Betty and Dolly? Betty and Dolly were cousin sisters of the poet's mother, and they had gone with her to the beach for paddling. And one more question. The poet's mother would have laughed at the snapshot. What does this laughter indicate? The poet's mother would have laughed at the photograph because she saw how strangely and how out of fashionably they had been dressed up for the holiday trip on the beach. Now after so many years, maybe after 30 years, maybe after 40 years, when she used to look back at that photograph, she used to remember, she used to smile that how peculiar, how awkwardly we had been dressed up for that particular snapshot, for that particular picture that was taken near the seashore. Now, stanza number 4. The sea holiday was our past, mine is our laughter, both wry with the labored ease of loss. Now, what questions we can frame from this line? Who went for the sea holiday in the past? The poet's mother had gone for the sea holiday in the past when she was a young girl. What does both refer to? Both refers to the poet as well as her mother. How does the poet feel when she remembers her mother? The poet experiences great sorrow when she remembers her mother who died many years ago. Explain, this line is very important. I already told that this line, there is an oxymoron, ease and loss. So both wry with the labored ease of loss. Both here refers to the mother who had died a while ago and the poet who has lost her mother. Wry is a reference to the struggles that the two women underwent to forget what they had lost. In case of the poet's mother, it was the loss of her childhood. In case of the poet, it was the death of her mother. Labored ease of loss is the relief that the two women got after laboring endlessly to forget their losses. How does the poet feel when she remembers her mother's sea holiday? The poet feels sad when she remembers the sea holiday of her mother, because now her mother is no longer alive to appreciate and to laugh at her heart's content after looking at that old photograph. That is all in this video. In my next video, I will discuss the last stanza from this poem. Thank you, students.